Hi everybody, this is AJ with Car Inspected. Today we are in Toronto and we are looking at this 2014 Mercedes-Benz GL350. It's got 113,000 kilometers on it. It's gray in color. Overall looks pretty decent. I see no sign of repaint or major accident. It is equipped with the BlueTEC diesel engine, V6. Headlights, taillights, all that stuff looks to be in good condition. All the windows seem to be good. We have all original Mercedes windows, and none of them are broken or chipped or anything like that. They all look pretty good. Windshield looks good. This right here is a little bit of water. It's not a chip or anything. And it is also, like I said, the original glass. So everything looks pretty good. Headlights look good. No major issues. Throughout there are some spots that have some little damage. Very minimal though, not too much. On this side we look pretty good. There's a little scratch here. You can see along that, there we go, as you can see along there. But other than that, this side looks pretty nice. There's a little damage on this rear bumper area. So this taillight is broken, well this reflector, sorry, is broken, and there is a little indication of a hit here. Looks like it took a bit of a bump right here. Everything looks lined up though, so we don't have any major issues. So go to the tailgate. Everything looks good back here. Vehicle is equipped with a trailer hitch. There is a little bump here, not as much damage to the other side, but there is a bit of a bump right there. Roof looks good as well, by the way. We have no real issues there. A couple of little spots here, some minor scratching. There has come some chips and some rust starting there. A couple of scratches along the door here. Again, pretty minor, kind of hard to see. There is a ding in this piece of trim here. You can see that in the light. And there are a little bit of a scratch on the front fender. This is the driver's side fender. This scratch goes from the fender and through to the door a little bit. And there's a couple of minor ones here and there. Some chips here. So nothing major, but there are a couple little things. There is a scratch here in the front bumper as well. So there's a couple of minor things, but for the most part, nothing major. Wheels, tires, brakes, everything looks pretty good. We have good years. These are from 2018. With a good amount of tread. I think it was 11/32 of tread. Yeah, 11 on the fronts, and they look pretty nice and even. No signs of issue. Suspension components all look pretty good as well. Airbags, it is in the up position right now, so we have a good amount of space here, so that adjustable suspension does work as it should. Brakes look pretty good up front. Rotors look okay. No major lip or anything, and the pads are doing pretty good. I'd say there's at least 50% left on them. Undercarriage looks pretty good on this side. All boots, axle boots, etc. all look good. Nothing's leaking. Everything's pretty good. Passenger side front. We find a matching 2018. There's the date, 2018 Goodyear. With about 11/32 of tread. And it all looks pretty good. Brakes are similar condition. Pretty good. About 50% or so left. Hard to see in there, but they are there. And its suspension components, etc., look pretty good over here as well. Now, it's going to be hard to see in the video, but there is... So, the suspension components look good, but like I said, it's going to be hard to see in the video. But there is a little bit of a leak. Looks like oil pan that you can see from here. I got some better shots of it, photos of it. But there is a... Unfortunately, it's a little hard to tell if it was a spill or a leak in the oil pan. To me, it looks like there's a slight leak in the oil pan. I don't see any major evidence of it here. A little bit damp under here. Other than that though, it looks pretty good under here. A little bit of dirt, but no rust or anything like that. Exhaust all looks good, no major damage. Everything seems to be pretty nice. In the back, we have a set of Goodyears. This is from 2016, so it's a little older. It's got about 10-30 seconds of tread. A little older, but not much more mileage on it at all. So they might have been put on at the same time, just a little older from the warehouse or something. A little bit of corrosion here on the center as well, nothing too major. Rear brakes also look pretty nice. Not a major lip, a little tiny bit of one, but not too bad. And the pads are about 45% or so on them. Wheel wells look good. Rear suspension looks good as well. Again, axle boots look okay. No major issues. Differential's not leaking or anything like that. Everything looks pretty nice under here. Trailer hitch looks good as well. Final wheel. Tire matches the other side. It's got about 10-30 seconds of tread. And it is a, this one's marked as a 2018. No major issues on the rim or anything like that. And brakes as well look pretty nice. About 45% or so. And same story as the other side. Suspension looks pretty good under here. No real issues. And no damage or rust or anything like that under here either. So we're gonna jump into the interior. Door does open by itself. It also closes by itself. I'll show you as I close. But everything in here looks pretty nice. No real issues. The spare tires here, tools are here, wheel locks and factory headsets. This one looks a little broken, but they are here. Three of them are there. Little cargo nets are all here. Everything seems to be set pretty much as it should. And headliner looks pretty nice as well, so you can see. A couple of very minor marks on the tailgate, but nothing to be upset about. As I said, this all seems to work. All the electronics that I've tested and looked at all seem to work just fine. Here we are in the right rear door panel. It all looks pretty good. A little scratch here, and there is some cracking in the wood grain along here. Again, you'll get better photos, but there is some there. Seats in the middle aisle here all look pretty nice. They are really goobed up from the detailer, but I don't see any major issues that I can tell. Cup holder looks good, etc. Carpet looks good as well here. Underneath, we have no major issues. And this center console piece, everything seems to work as it should. Everything looks good. Seats fold down as they should by using this button. So it does exactly what it's supposed to do. And the carpet looks nice. Rear seats look nice and barely used. And all this stuff does seem to work and look just as it should. Lights work. These buttons here for the seats do work. Oh, I'm pushing it the wrong way. There we go. So as you see, they do exactly as they should. Down and up. With no issues. As we see, it has factory Mercedes DVD players. I think they have to turn on when the car is on. But everything is there. The sunshades, everything looks good in the headliner. Front seat looks nice. Again, on this door panel with some cracking on the wood grain, which you'll see better in the photos. Other than that though, door panels look nice with no issues. Front seats look good, no major wear and tear. Leather looks nice, nice and shiny. Carpets look good. Some small foot marks and a bit of a crack on the wood grain that goes from here, you can see, up through to there. dash top and everything looks good though. Owner's manual and other trinkets are in here. We go around to the driver's side. And we see that that is in just as good as condition as the rest. Door panel looks pretty nice. The wood grain here is not cracked, so that's a positive. And this seat looks just as good as well, with no issues. There is a little bit of markings, very hard to see, a little yellow mark and a slight scratch. We're being really picky, but there. And this all works just as good as well. Just like it should. Carpets look nice down here. And again, factory DVD player, etc. All looks pretty good. Here we are in the driver's door. Slight crackage through here. And a couple little marks, but nothing too major. All the switches seem to look good. Power seats seem to work. So all that stuff does seem to work as it should. Got all these extra buttons. Everything looks good there, and the driver's seat looks pretty good as well. Minimal wear and tear. No real problems. All looks pretty nice. Dash top looks good. Is pretty nice. All looks pretty good. Buttons all look good. This wood grain is all in good shape with no issues. Everything seems to be where it should. And here is your suspension settings. And like I said, it did go up and down. Everything looks pretty nice. No issues. I did test the windows. They all seem to work. All these things seem to work. Radio works. We can show you real quick. A little bit of a noise on startup, but that's mostly a diesel-y noise. So the radio is on. And everything does work. Navigation. Yep, we are on reserve fuel. So everything seems to work. These all work. Everything looks pretty good. We have no codes or check engine lights or anything of that nature on. Everything looks good. We're gonna pop the hood. Look in there real quick. And we find no major issues under here. I popped this cover off and you'll see photos of that. There is a little bit of oil around this area. It is hard to determine if it's just spillage from somebody adding oil or if there's a leak there, but you will see those photos. Belts, hoses, and everything look pretty good looking down in here. You'll see better photos again, and I see no other signs of issue. There's a little bit of oil around the turbo as well. In general, diesels are pretty dirty though, so but you will see the photos. Coolant is in here. We're good. We're clean and good to negative 43. Your brake fluid is under this panel and it's good. We're at 2% humidity, so there is no issues there. Your oil checks out fine. The dipstick is right back there, that yellow. And it's we came back with a green light, so we have no real issues. And as I said, the oil looks pretty good. There's no frothing or any issues. It's a little dark, but again, it's a diesel, so that is usually pretty dark. Battery, the charging lug, jump lug, and anyway, where I put it is here. And that was pretty good too, sitting at 13 and charging at 15. So we are looking good there. You know what, I'm gonna start it up so you can hear it for a second. But it is nice and quiet. So there you have it. 2014 Mercedes-Benz GL350. As usual, thanks for watching. This is AJ with Car Inspected, and we'll see you next time.